Hi guys, today I'm going to do a review of my sleep system that I use when I'm out camping. So, it consists of a Flextail Zero Pump, Thermarest, NeoAir X-Lite NXT, mat, and my recently purchased Zen Bivy bed, which is now available in the UK. Now, there's no paid promotion here, this is just the stuff I use. This is the first time I've used this. So we're going to get this out of the box, set it all up, and let's see how we go. So, the Flextail pump comes with numerous adapters. This is the one that fits mine. It's got about 5 or 6, so it should fit any sort of adapters. It's got a little CR1238A battery in, which you can just recharge. So, really cool that. Now, if you open it up, the battery's inside, very simple, really nice little tool. That will do you about 25 minutes of airtime, apparently. I've used it 3 times and it's still only had to charge it up the other day, so always worth taking a spare battery with you. Anyway, first things first, we'll get the airbed pumped up. So, that's the Neo, Thermarest, whatever they will be, they love all these acronyms, don't they? Anyway. This is the regular size. In hindsight, I probably should have got the larger size, but that's hindsight's always a wonderful thing. This pump basically works 2 ways. It just works, and then one end inflates, the other end exflates, and that's all shown there. Really is as simple as put that on. Open up the valve. Put your little pump on, and it really is as simple as then just pressing that, and that will then pump that up. You just leave that to run, it'll do it in a few minutes. I've also got to back up one of those, air bags that you just pull up manually, but I've never had to use it yet, but it's always good to have a backup, especially in the cold weather, because, batteries can go a bit less. It's a bit easier in that sort of weather. They don't tend to last long, especially GoPro for some reason, but generally batteries as they are. But we'll just time that, a little timer going, and we'll just see how that goes. So no paid promotions on this. These have only just become available in the UK, like I said, so I'm really looking forward to that. So this, while we're letting that blow up, this Zen Bivy bag comes in a nice net bag. However, it doesn't come with a compression sack, so I bought a Sea to Summit compression sack just to put it in, and that will compress that down to about a third. I think this weighs about 1.5 kilos. I'll put the details or something like that. So it's a little bit heavy for some of the ones, but I'm at that age now where essentially it's all about comfort rather than getting obsessed with lightweight and spending lots of money. So I'll just unpack this, which is down filled, but the down is sourced ethically. So on the tag there, it will tell you when and where it's from, and you can trace it, etc., etc. So that's almost done now. So I don't know how long that took, but that was literally a minute or so. Take that off, tighten that up. That is pretty solid now, as you can see. So that was blown up relatively quick. So back to the old Zen Bivy bed. Put my head off again. So we'll just have to undo that because they love tying things up. Should have done this before. I actually ordered the wrong size, but Zen Bivy were really good. I basically went back to them and said, look, ordered the wrong size, didn't read the website properly because I'm a bit impulsive. And they sent it back to the refund, job done within a matter of days, and they refunded the day that they received it, and really impressed with the service there. So we'll just undo this bag, unwrap it. This is a comfort rating of -7 degrees and a limit of -12 degrees C, which is pretty good really, and probably do me for most sort of camping that I'm going to do in winter. The other thing is it's more like a quilt. It's I'll show you a picture up, but it's like a quilt. You can use it as a quilt or you can zip it up. They also do a lightweight version which has just got clips on the side, so they're worth looking at. They're a little bit cheaper, but this one is a zip up one. Now the real benefit of this is it's got like a sheet that goes over the airbed and then straps on, so in theory your bag shouldn't slip off a bed. It's also got like a hood where you can put your pillow. So let me just get that out. What I will do, I'm going to go out on a camp and I'll show you it in use with a pillow and everything. So if we unpack this, push my head up again, you can see there's a sheet here with the strap that goes around your sleeping bag, and this zips on to the sides. The bag actually zips on here, so you can take that off, etc., etc. But this essentially will loop over the top of your sleeping bag. So, and there's different sizes, so there's a different size sheet. They can do 20, 25, and a bit bigger. So this will slip over the top of the bag like that, and this strap, which is adjustable, will go underneath. So if you do that, that goes under there. I've put all the ranges up. This then hooks over the end here and that end, then the same at the bottom. Nearly melting my Flextail pump there. As you can see, that then hooks over the bottom. The drawstring here, so you can adjust it. That now is hooked on. That was really easy to do. This is a large size, zip down the sides, so you can use it for fleece. You can also zip off here. As you can see, you've got your sheets under there, so it is a fleece, it's not an all-round bag. But I have this, my sleeping mat underneath, which is an Expedition one, which is quite good. So between that and that, then you've got this really nice hood here where your pillow can go, and also your head. Keep it really warm there, little pocket there if you need to put anything in there. You can also, at this end, you can do a drawstring again, so you can turn it into a popper bag, or if you're like me, don't know about you, but I really do like having my feet out. So again, you can open that up with a simple press stud. You can open it up down this side as well. So yeah, really useful that. Really useful. Do like that. So again, plenty of opportunities to turn it into almost like a proper sleeping bag like that, or to have it open, because I'm one of those, just like I say, likes my feet there. So yeah, really looking forward to using that. Really good. Nice bit of kit. That was really easy to set up. You know, you can use it as a proper quilt. They recommend leaving, my head's gone again, they recommend leaving one side off, just so that you can use it as a, you know, don't slide out. That shouldn't, in theory, that shouldn't roll off there so easy. But it needs a bit of tightening up. But I'm going to try that out on a camp. But in theory, once we adjusted that properly, and it will adjust a bit more down here. So I've got the large one, but you can really sort of tighten that up. That's going nowhere now. Again, on the back, just tighten up a bit more than needed. So that's really in place now, and that's not going to go anywhere. So I'm forever sliding on a slight slope. You know, you should be pretty good there. As you can see, it's a bit longer than the bed. It's not a big problem. My feet will be there, it can move up a little bit, but yeah. Bang on that, mate. So that's my sleep system. I'll break that into several different reviews as well on the different bits of kit, but I'll put all the info up. But yeah, see how we get on with a camp on that. But that should keep you warm all through winter, and even in summer you can just use that as a quilt, take it off, you know, etc, etc. If you want a bit of extra warmth, if it's really cold, you could potentially put a liner in there, but I think I'll just put more clothes on. But I'm a fairly hot sleeper, I do tend to get warm. But yeah, so that's the Zenbivy bed, the Thermarest Neolite air mattress. And then I've got an Expedition mat. They've all got pretty good R ratings again, I'll put the details up. But that should be a pretty good system for winter, hopefully. This is the Thermarest pillow that I use. So a bit bulky, but pretty comfy. That sort of packs down. Then you can basically pack that out, and that will fit just nicely in there, keep me nice and warm. Nice and snuggled up there. And then this just folds over like a big quilt. And then you can, like, at the top, you know, you can tie it together here and stuff and make it quite insulated. You can unzip it at the sides, like I say. But yeah, I'm really looking forward to that. That's really going to be really good for me. And like I say, if it gets really cold, you just zip it all the way up here. So yeah, super duper that. Really looking forward to that. This will be the dogs. So yeah, anyway, that is the Zen Bivy bed. So that was a Zen Bivy bed. I'm just going to show you how to take this Thermarest down. This is, you know, a really good bed kit. You simply undo that, turn this toggle here around like that. And then all we have to do is roll this up. Extremely lightweight. Like I said, I'll put all the info up at the end about the different specs. This would have paid a bit, you know, to have a bit of better quality. This can go quite rock hard. I find that I sometimes have to soften it a bit because it's too hard. So I've never had that with an airbed before, and it stays inflated all night even if I sit on it. So yeah, really impressed with this bit of kit. Into the 4 centimeters, so it's quite thick. A nice bit of luxury. It's all about the comfort, like I said earlier. I'm at an age now where I'm not obsessed with going around with a bit of lightweight, a bit of heavier weight, a bit more comfort, I'm fine. It'll keep me a bit fitter. So yeah, that is now sealed. You can turn the valve back to the horizontal position, do it up, that packs down. Really small into your rucksack. There is a Zen Bivy bed now. I've done it into a fleece. So my feet go in to this bit at the bottom here. Let me see that in this light. In here. And then this bit is open or it can be zipped up. Pillows in the end. So we shall see how that goes tonight. But it looks bloody comfy. So there's a Zen Bivy in the bed. Absolutely toasty as hell, mate. Very easy to set up. Packed it down into the Cepa Summit bag. Can't fault it, mate. That's the best sleeping bag I've ever had, I think.
So this is the spec for the Thermarest Neo Air X-Lite NXT regular sleeping mat. As you can see, it only weighs 350 grams. Dimensions are pretty good when packed down at 23 by 10 centimetres. The R value is 4.5, which if you look at the table there, gives it a rating of somewhere between all year round and winter, and a temperature of minus 11 to minus 17 degrees C. So more than suitable and adequate for anything that the UK can throw at it. This is a Zen Bivy bed, UK available now. This is the full fat version, as I call it. They also do a lightweight version and an ultralight version, but this is the full fat version. Two things you really need to consider when you're looking at this is your height and the overarm measurement, which is around your entire body with your arms by your side, which then leads to three different sizes: regular, large, and extra large. The measurement in inches underneath each of those, 20, 25 and 30, refers to the sheet sizes, which I'll come on to next. There are different sizes of sheet. As you can see there, a 20, a 25, a 30, a 40 and a 50, the 40 and 50 being doubles. And it's all around the width and the size of the mattress. So pick the correct size in terms of width and length, and then get the appropriate sheet size and match that up with your size of your bag that you need. Final item in the sleep system is my XBed Flex Mat. This is actually a summer mat, has an R value of 1.5, which takes you down to around 5 degrees. But, you know, it does more than what I need to do. It's a one-person mat, it weighs 325 grams, it packs down to a size of 52 by 13 by 15 centimetres.